So today we have gone through the automotive braking system introductions. So this will be today's agenda. So who can take up this course and the history of brake systems, definition and the function of brakes, brake foundations and automotive brake system, future and hybrid brakes and the career progression and the job opportunity. In final, we have the question and answer sessions. So let me get to the history of brakes. So generally speaking, what is brakes? The brakes is used to control the system to reduce the speed or halt the system. So over the century, we had so many brakes evolved in the brake system. So there are many forms of brakes have been developed in over the years. So let me see. The wooden brakes, this is the very earliest brake systems used in the global. So it is used in the horse cart and the bull cart vehicles. So this is in this brake system, how they are using is the wooden block is placed nearby the vehicle wheel steel rim sections. So when the brake lever is pulled, the wooden block rub against the steel rim and it helps to slow down the vehicles. So, and again, the drum brake system, it was evolved in 1900s. So the drum brake system consists of two major objects. One is the brake shoe, another one is brake drum. One is fixed and then another one is rotating part. So the brake drum is the rotating part and the brake pad is the fixed part. When the brake is applying, the fixed part is rubbing against the rotating part. Thus the vehicle will stop and slow down. Again, the disc brake system. This also the consists of two major component. One is stationary and another one is rotating. The stationary one is that caliper unit, which consists of the brake pads. And the rotating unit is a disc pad. So when we apply the brake, the caliper unit rub against the disc pad. It will reduce the vehicle speed and halt the vehicles. So this is of the history of the brakes, how they are evolved in over the centuries. So let me see the definitions and function of brakes, automotive brakes. So brake is the one of the important control of the vehicle because this is the active safety system. It consists of combination of several interactive parts. So it's absorb the energy from the moving object and to slow down the vehicle with help of frictions. So as I said, one part is the rotating part, another one is the fixed part. When we apply the brakes, the fixed part rubbing against the rotating part, it will create the friction and slow down the vehicle. So this is the simple definition of brake system. So what is the function of brake system? Like I said, the function is when we apply the brake, the friction is creating. So the kinetic energy of the vehicle into created into the heat energy, and that heat energy is deposited in the atmosphere. So how it will be done is we'll be applying the brake, the fixer part of the fixer part of brake pad at that caliper unit, which is rubbing against the rotating part. The rotating part, whether that is the disc brake or the drum brake, which is coupled with the vehicle axial, which is the rotating wheel. So the fixer part expanding and rubbing against part, it will regenerating the energy, one energy into another energy, and that heat energy dissipated in the atmosphere. So we will see the brake foundation. So whatever the brake systems have evolved and so many braking systems have developed, the ultimate end is the brake foundation. So this won't be changed. So majorly there are two types of brake foundation is using in all over the globe for the automobile industries. So let me explain what are the brake foundations we have, how they are using. So this is the one type of brake foundation, that is the drum brake system, mechanical drum brake system. So here I will explain the each part and I will explain how it will function. So let me explain the each part. So this one is the cam, which is used to expand the brake pads. So here, this one is brake lining. Brake lining is the friction part, which is held up on the brake pad. So when we apply the brake, the brake friction, the brake lining only rub against the brake drum. So this one is the brake drum, which is coupled with the vehicle axial. So this one is the rotating part. So this inner part is the fixed part. So this one is the brake shoe. So the brake lining is mounted over the brake shoes. So when we applying the brake, so the cam will rotate and expanding the brake shoes. So when that expanding is happening, the brake lining rub against the brake drum. So the rotating part, which is the brake drum coupled with the wheel, due to this friction, it will reduce the speed. Ultimately, it will stop the vehicle at the certain condition. So this is the simple components in the drum brake. Over the development and the technology has developed, so many things are added, but this is the basics. So let me show you the video of how the drum brakes are functioning. Here, for your information, I muted the video, so I will explain orally when the video is playing. So as I said, this is the foundation brake system. This one is backplate assembly, and this one is a brake drum. This one is wheel. This is the coupled nuts. So the wheel, the brake drum, and completely coupled with the wheel. So this one is the brake drum. So the brake drum is mostly made up of cast iron. So this one is the back plate assembly. So this one is the back plate assembly. This also coupled with the vehicle wheel assembly, which is coupled in wheel axle. So this one is the brake pad. So the above the friction is the brake lining. The friction plate is the brake lining. So this one is the component used to expand the brake pads. Either it can be cam or the piston type. So when we applying the brake, this kind of operation takes place inside. So the pistons expands the brake pad. So when that expansion happens, this brake lining, the friction part, is rubbing against the brake drum. So this one is the reactor spring. So after you release the brake pedal, the spring helps to get the normal position of the brake pads. When you release the brake pedal, it helps to retain the position, that's the same position. And this assembly used to adjust the brake lining, because over a period that brake lining is gets the thickness will be reduced because of continuous operation of braking. So this can be used to expand the brake pad. If the thickness is reduced, we can expand, so the distance between the brake lining to the drum can be reduced. And this unit is used for the handbrake systems. So this one is can be done by manually. You can see when we apply the handbrake systems, it pull this lever and the brake pad will expand against the brake drum. So this was the operations of mechanical brake drum. So next one type is the disc brake. This is also the similar operation of our mechanical drum brake. Like that, a disc brake also operating. In disc brake also, we have several components. I will explain the each components and how it will function. I will explain one by one. So like that, here also the two major parts. One is the fixed part, the caliper unit. Another one is the rotating part, which is the disc. So the rotating part, disc, is coupled with the wheel hub. So this stationary object, which is a caliper unit. So the caliper unit consists of pistons. Here, the brake pad is mounted in the pistons. So what the operation takes place here is, when the brake pedal is pressed, the pressure is applied on the piston. So when the pressure is applied on the piston moves forward, and this brake pad rubbed against the rotating part, which is this disc. This one is the rotating part. So the brake pad rubbed against the disc, and the braking operation takes place. So it will reduce the speed of the vehicle. This is the main function of the disc brake system. So let me show you the video of the operation of the disc brakes. So these are the disc brake components: wheel hub assembly and the disc rotor. So this is the wheel hub assembly. So this the disc is coupled with the wheel hub assembly. So this is this disc plate. So why these holes are provided is when the friction is happening, it gets more heat. So that heat should be eliminated. So the drilled vent holes are provided in the disc. So this one is the caliper unit. As I said, this one is the brake pad, which is rubbing against the disc. This one is a caliper brackets, pins, boots. This is the inner brake pad and the outer brake pad. This is the caliper frame and this one is the piston. So the brake pads are mounted on the pistons. Here you can see this is the bonjour nut. The pressure we have applied, it comes to only this bonjour nut, which may be the pneumatic pressure or the hydraulic pressure. So when we applying the brake pad rub against the rotating disc. Now you can see when the wheel is rotating, when we apply the brake fluid, which is hydraulic or the pneumatic, whatever it may be. So it pushes the piston towards the disc side. So the rotating wheel will stop. We can see also in the top view. So when we are applying the brake pad rub against the rotating disc, this causes the slow down the vehicle. So when we release the brake pedal due to the back pressure, the operation will resume as the normal condition. So this is how the disc brake works on the wheel side. So now next topic, we move on to automotive brake systems. So before that, what we have seen is a brake foundation, which is the ultimate end of the braking system. It will be whatever the brake system, whether it may be hydraulic brakes or air brakes, but the foundation will be the two types. That one is the drum brake or disc brake. As we see also in our motor vehicles, two wheelers, we can see there is two type of brakes, whether they can be a drum brake or disc brake. Like that in passenger vehicle, four wheel cars also having this kind of arrangements, either that's a drum brake or the disc brake. So now what we are going to see is automotive braking system. The brake system means the complete brake system, what globally using in the automotive industry. So this one is the simple layout I am showing of the hydraulic braking systems. So let me explain one by one components, and I will show you the working of operation of the hydraulic brake system. So the hydraulic brake system works on the principle of Pascal principle, which means when the pressure is applied on the closed container, the pressure will be equally spitted outed in the all vents. That kind of principle using in the hydraulic brake system. So in hydraulic brake system, the main components are the brake pedal and the master cylinder and the distributor valve and the brake lines. So this one is the foundation brakes, either the drum brake or the disc brake. This is the ultimate end of the brakes, which is coupled in the wheel. So how it will operate is when we applying the brake, the pressure is created on the master cylinder. So the master cylinder distribute the pressure into the each wheels by the help of distributor valve. So by the use of distributor valve, the pressure is equally distributed to the all wheels. So when the separation is occurred, like that, what we seen in previous videos, the piston will expand and cause the brakes braking effect on the each wheels. While seeing this layout in the front wheels, they are taking the drum brake operation. When the pressure is applied, the brake pad is rubbing against the brake drum, the vehicle stops. Like that, in rear wheels, the caliper, in caliper, the piston wheel will expand and rub against the rotating disc, and the brake wheel happens. So let me show you the video of how that hydraulic brakes will work. By the way, at the same time, I will explain you in the videos. So this one is the hydraulic braking systems. This one is a hydraulic brake pedal. This one is push rod, which is coupled with the brake valve. It's termed as a servo, which is used to build up the pressure. This one is the master cylinder, what we have shown seen in schematic. This one is reservoir, which is used to fill up the brake fluid. So these are the brake lines. So in this operation, what are doing, when we apply the brake manually, it transfers the manual operation into the hydraulic operation into the wheels. So the master cylinder converts the hydraulic pressure from the driver's side and distributes equally to the all the wheels. So when we applying the brake, see from here are the pressure wheels distributing to all the wheels. And when the brake pedal is released, the, due to the back pressure, all the wheel is released from the braking effect. When the brake pedal is pushing, when the brake pedal is released, when the brake pedal is released, this wheel, due to back pressure, all the pressure will reversed and the wheel is rotating. When we press the brake, the pressure is built up and it will restrict the wheel from the motion. As I said, for each wheel, the hydraulic lines applying the pressure, and the piston, which is in caliper, pushes towards the rotating disc and restrict the rotation of the wheel. So this is how the hydraulic brake systems are working.